2 years of lockdowns have seen more of us spending time on the couch and in front of screens, leading to a rise in back pain.
And chiropractor Jason Gilbert has a new book out, The Secret to a Healthy Spine, and Jason is with us now to get tips on how to get rid of that pain in your back. There are a lot of people out there who are suffering back pain, who live with it every day.
Exactly. There's so many people that they say that 7% of the population at any one time is suffering from back pain, and 80% at some time in their lives, like the world population, independently of what country you live in, what age, what you're doing.
80%.
Exactly.
Like every day, living with it. Jason, you warned us that after 2 years of being in lockdowns that we'd be living our best lives when we came out. Have you been seeing any Freedom Day injuries?
Look, I have, because it's pretty simple to understand. Imagine getting any machine, let's take a bike that's been in the garage for a long time, without use. That was our spine during lockdown. Then all of a sudden we take it out and we expect that it's going to be functioning the same, but it's not. And most of us find out via pain.
Yeah.
Okay, because
right.
The spine's a machine. Like, it needs to move. It's happy when it's moving. So what we're seeing is that a lot of people that were thrown into lockdown without being able to prepare their home workspace were actually compromising it even more. So it's not only the sedentary lifestyle that was promoted, but also the fact that it was compromised in its function. So the spine intelligently, via the brain, causes pain.
Yeah.
The same way a car advises us when we need to put oil in. It's just a normal signal.
Mm. It is crazy. And that's a staggering number, 80%. I mean, we often hear that people had stronger backs back in the day as well. But is it a modern-day problem? I mean, what are we doing so much different than people before? Has back issues always been there?
Yeah, that's a good point, actually. I would say, okay, because we don't know, there's not much documented from hundreds of years ago, but I would say that our lives now, when they're going towards technology and convenience, it's also taking us towards more of a sedentary lifestyle.
Mm. Wow.
So tip number one, we need to move more.
Yeah.
Mm.
Okay, once again, it's a machine. No machine, no mechanical, I guess, apparatus is going to function at its best without actually being used.
I think the last couple of years we all enjoyed wearing active wear and lounging around in our slippers or, you know, going barefoot at home. Heels, when we're wearing heels again, but when we're going out. And are handbags also an issue?
They are an issue, like heels and handbags, because handbags, the fashionable ones, seem to be larger than what they need to be. And a lot of women take advantage of that without knowing, just put too much in there. So it ends up being really heavy. So once again, is it bad? It depends on how well the woman's prepared. Is she aware that changing sides when she uses it's important?
Mm.
There's all these things. It sounds quite daunting, but it's not. It's actually common sense. But no one ever teaches us how to use a spine.
Well, that would go for any bag, like a suitcase, a briefcase.
Exactly.
Anything that you can carry.
A tiny bag called a wallet. That as well. This is one that always blew my mind as well. The fact that even carrying your wallet in your back pocket, there's certain things that I would try and be conscious of, I suppose. I suppose it'd be similar to having your phone in your back pocket as well.
That sounds like a joke.
No, it does, doesn't it? But it does. But I'm still, I've heard it somewhere. So I'm like, right, but don't put the wallet in the back pocket. But my biggest thing, I suppose, is the thing that I can't control in terms of when I'm asleep. Sleeping positions that people have, because I sleep on my belly.
Yeah.
And if I'm not on my belly, I'm on my side like a pretzel all twisted up and stuff, which has a huge impact on people.
That has a massive impact, and we're asleep. So those pain signals, which are positive, we've got to remember that pain's positive. Hunger's positive, isn't it? It leads us towards eating. Feeling tired's positive, it leads us towards sleeping. So pain is a reflex that the brain uses to advise us not to do something.
Right on.
But when we're sleeping, we're not getting that signal quite as strong as what we should.
Mm.
So we can spend hours with our neck turned to one direction, left or right, and most people who do it chronically will have difficulty turning the other side.
Yeah, okay.
And you can often, when you're familiar with people and these problems, you can actually palpate their spines and guess. If they tell you it's face down, you can also guess, okay, you turn your head to the right, because it shortens the muscles on that side. So if we look at the spine once again, it's a machine. Well, it's got to be used equally both sides. The other thing with sleeping face down is your low back.
Yeah.
It increases that curve. So, no, definitely not. We're not meant to sleep face down. We're meant to sleep on our back, on a firm mattress, or on our side.
Mm.
With a mattress, it can be a little
softer. I think we can all relate to that.
Yeah. Is that wallet thing legitimate, though?
Dead
because
set,
I don't have no money in my wallet. I thought that was the problem. Like, people are saying, well, stop carrying coins.
Yeah.
But it's a legitimate thing.
It was actually called creditcarditis. right. when it was discovered. I think it's probably 20 years ago that phrase was coined. But what happens is it's not the fact the weight of it is going to cause problems. So when a man sits down and it's in the back pocket, it actually causes, I guess, an imbalance between the left and right side of the, okay. the pelvis. Mm. And with time, that causes shortening of muscles. Sometimes it gets a sciatic nerve, which goes down the leg. You've got leg pain that you often don't relate to the cause.
So, Jason, your book, The Secret to a Healthy Spine, focuses on prevention. Is that because it's much better to prevent back pain, obviously, than to cure
exactly.
Spinal damage?
No, for sure. And I've been working in this field for 30 years. Mm. And what most frustrated me was to be, I guess, relieving people's pain, mm. but also seeing people, let's say, 50, 60, 70, that didn't know what they were doing for decades before was actually causing problems that they'd never get over,
yeah.
that they'd be limited by for life. And so to see that most of us focus on the cause or the effect of the problem, sorry, the symptom, the effect mm. of the problem instead of the cause. And for 5 years, I just noted down all the problems that I was encountering and I just noticed that the list grew pretty fast and then it levelled out. So we're all doing the same things. And it's not our fault because no one ever sits down and teaches us mm. the same way a dentist teaches us how to brush our teeth correctly.
Yeah.
And
it's
most
very
of
true.
Us finish our lives with our teeth yeah. intact still. But no one does that in general for our spine.
Well, fantastic.
So that's why prevention's better than
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's super. But the information's out there and it's in this book, The yeah. Secret to a Healthy Spine. I'll be reading that.
Thank
I'm
going
to steal that.
No, thank you, guys.
Thanks for that one.